Good company tonight as you travel to your holiday destination. This is a live look tonight at 35W and 694 in New Brighton. You see things moving along pretty nicely. The roads are wet out there, but they're not icy, so that makes driving a little bit easier out there this evening.
And we have team coverage as we monitor travel both on the roads and in the air. We start with meteorologist Jonathan Uhas with what drivers can expect over the next 24 hours. Jonathan.
Ellen, we'll have some scattered slippery spots. The roads right now are not great in all places. Here in the Twin Cities, again, we're just seeing wet roadway conditions, but to our north, up toward Duluth, there's some snow that's causing slippery conditions there. And then also to our south on I-35, down toward Des Moines, from about just south of Mason City through Ames, Iowa, and then right into Des Moines, snow is flying there as well. It's not really accumulating, but as far as visibility, it is making driving a little bit difficult. Now, for tomorrow, within 200 miles of the Twin Cities, it'll be just fine tomorrow. But the one problem spot, if you're traveling in the afternoon by air or by car, right about 90 miles within of Chicago, they're going to have heavy snow in the afternoon and evening hours. So that's going to probably cause airport delays and also driving delays. So almost a micro snowstorm happening there tomorrow. But up here looks pretty good. All points west looks pretty good. I'll detail the rest of that forecast too coming up at 6:15.
See you then. Thanks, Jonathan. You could call our mild December weather a holiday miracle for air travelers in the metro area. Doesn't matter if you're flying in or flying out. Catherine Johnson's live now at Minneapolis-St. Paul International. So, Catherine, what are you seeing out there?
Ellen, people are in such good spirits out here at the airport today. I want to show you this card that was just randomly placed here at the airport. I just found it a few minutes ago. It says, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. And inside it reads, Happy Holidays. I know traveling can be rough sometimes. I hope you have a great day and happy holidays, which is just the tone that you're feeling all throughout the airport tonight. The lines are short. People are moving right along. And believe it or not, the arrivals all over the board are either coming in on time or some of them are even landing here early. While most of us wait for a white Christmas, those patiently looking for the most important presents to arrive are just fine ringing in the season in the rain.
We're feeling blessed.
From Atlantic to Pacific, the Mullen siblings had to worry about flights making it to Minnesota from all over the nation.
Atlanta, Utah, New Hampshire, Boston.
This was Mom's wish. She's passed away, but it was important to her that we continue to get the family together as often as we possibly can. So this is a tribute to her.
Stress is no surprise during the holidays. Sometimes it's enough to frazzle even the finest fur. New dad Izzy Perry is tasked with toting 4 bags and a baby.
I'm glad we didn't have to go through like Denver or Chicago.
Right? I think Minneapolis knows how to handle the winter weather.
Minnesota ranks in as the 5th best airport in the nation when it comes to avoiding delays, with only one noted hour of tough travel between 6 and 7 p.m., according to Travel and Leisure magazine.
It wouldn't be the same without being able to come home.
The good news is wherever your family may be flying in from, there's still time. Time for a few delays, time to enjoy a good holiday hug, and just enough time for a little snow to fall by Christmas.
When we're here and it's going to all work out, we'll wait for the white.
And we've got a good last-minute gift idea to share with you tonight. I called 3 travel agencies throughout the metro today, and they told me that if you're still looking for something to do and you don't necessarily love traveling during the holidays, you can get online right now. You can book a trip to the Caribbean or Mexico. Right now, the fares are extremely low for winter trips, either in January or in February. You'll still get those really low fares. So remember, you got that tip from me. I might have to partake in it myself tonight. Live at Minneapolis-St. Paul International Airport, Catherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
And the weather does not look as good in January, so it would be a good time to get out of town. Well, before you fly out, head to KSTP.com.